Today is a new day for some of Australia's lowest paid workers. A wage bump and a super boost makes for a happy start to the new financial year. But there is another side to it as cost of living pressures get even tighter thanks to a power price and phone bill hike. So where are you winning and where are you losing?
Australia's lowest paid workers are ringing in the new financial year with a pay rise. An extra dollar an hour as the 5.2% minimum wage increase kicks in.
And it is the biggest increase we've had for many, many years.
As of today, all employees will get a boost to their superannuation from 10% to 10.5%, and contributions will now be made no matter how little you earn, but talk to the boss to avoid a rude shock.
Are they putting it on top of your existing salary package, or will it be taken out of your take-home pay?
Obligations for job seekers will be overhauled with a points-based system for job applications and interviews to access welfare, while Centrelink payments under the family tax benefit can be an extra $200, and so-called combined families will get higher childcare subsidies.
There are a range of areas where we want to try and address the cost of living challenges, but this is a big challenge.
Really hurting the hip pocket? A power price hike up to 20% for some customers. Telstra's dialing up phone bills too. And remember your health insurance increase getting deferred back in April? That honeymoon may be over.
The best thing you really can do is to shop around, see if there is a better deal available for you.
And there's been a huge backlash to the federal government's decision to cut pandemic measures from today.
Like telehealth consultations over 20 minutes and no more leave disaster payments for the COVID positive who can't work.
At the very least, these payments should be in place until there is no longer requirements to have to quarantine and isolate if you have COVID-19.
Chloe Boris for 10 News First.